Going from game-breaking receiver in the NFL to a successful entrepreneur is hardly a sure thing, as you know. Our next guest, though, has done just that. Mohsin Mohammed spent 14 seasons in the league with the Carolina Panthers and Chicago Bears, still holds the record, in fact, for the longest touchdown reception in Super Bowl history. Today, he is a partner at the private equity firm Axum Capital, which focuses on small and mid-sized companies. He is with us live. It's good to see you. Welcome.
Scott, thanks for having me.
You know, I had no idea what you were up to. I hadn't heard your name in a long time, and I saw a feature on you before a football game, and I was taken by your story. And if people are surprised by what you're doing now, it doesn't seem like you would be, because you have described yourself as an entrepreneur trapped in a football player's body. Tell me about that.
You know, it just started at an early age. And, you know, I just think of myself as more than just a football player. I'm more complete. And I've always had interest outside of playing the sport. And, you know, football has just provided, you know, an opportunity for me to explore other things I was interested in.
What I didn't realize was you founded Axum while you were still playing.
Wasn't very easy, yeah. But the last couple of years of my NFL career, starting in 2008 when I signed my a contract with the Carolina Panthers to come back to Charlotte, I started putting the framework for the private equity fund together, and met some interesting guys. Really love my partners, you know, Raymond Groth and Dennis Akayensu, that we all came together and started building the infrastructure of this fund. And so, you know, my teammates used to say, you know, Moose, are you a football player or business guy? Because, you know, I can't tell what it is you are. You're coming to work with these suits and the whole deal, right?
What's more fun?
You know, we closed a couple of deals this week, and I felt like I was running out the tunnel again. So, you know, you can easily compare, you know, closing great deals and, you know, accomplishing great things for your portfolio companies to great wins, you know, and there's a lot of football that translates over to business, a lot of similarities.
Yeah. You invest, I said, in mostly small and mid-sized businesses. You have a pretty good foray into the restaurant biz, which I'm wondering how you've managed all of that given the pandemic.
Well, I'll tell you, Scott, we have amazing CEOs at both of our companies. Steve Weigel is doing an amazing job at Wyoming Cafe. And on the other side, Dennis Pfaff with Backyard Burgers. But we quickly got several things in place for both our portfolio companies, right-sizing the companies, you know, dealing with vendors and a variety of different things to right-size our companies and set them on a course to be not only stable but flourish during COVID-19. And there were a number of measures that we put in place that now are playing themselves off. And I think it also starts, Scott, with our investment thesis, though, because we went after businesses that were predicated on the food, right? It wasn't about just doing transactions. We really took our time and picked two portfolio companies that we believed in. And even though it took us a little bit more time to close on those deals, we thought for that first one, it was paramount that we picked two companies that we thought can sustain things like this, economic ebbs and flows. And so I think we're doing a good job with
your story is inspirational too, which I mentioned on Twitter. It's a story of second chances, and a second chance that you got earlier in your life from Nick Saban, who was your college coach. Is that correct?
Yeah, Nick Saban was my college coach at Michigan State. And, you know, Scott, I know you grew up in South Florida, and most of the people watching this show know that, you know, when we're kids, we're probably happy, but we didn't have cell phones back then, right? And so, you know, there were some things that went on, and Nick Saban gave me an opportunity to get back on the field and prove myself. And it's a great story, Scott. You know, I started 1 year of college football and went on to play 14 years in the National Football League. And this guy's like, you know, Nick Saban that gave me an opportunity. George Perlis, who recruited me, but Nick Saban, who really gave me that opportunity to be a starter at the college level and show what I can do. And from that point on, you know, the rest is history.
I love the way you're sort of thinking about what your legacy is going to be. I've thought about what the Muhammad dynasty, what your name means and what kind of impact you can have. What is our purpose, you said, and how do we want to influence and change and affect the world? That is my North Star. That says a lot.
Yes. Well, you know, I'm a deep thinker. You know, I have a very eclectic background. I am, you know, a product of this country in so many different ways. And, you know, seeing this country move forward and being a part of it in a, you know, a material way is who I am. And it's a part of my North Star. It's what guides me. And when we make investment decisions, you know, there is a Obviously, we want returns, but we think those returns are generated by different things, focusing on people, focusing on, you know, great fundamentals and core things within core businesses. So, you know, we get returns, but we I don't think we look at it the same way that most private equity firms do. And we think that once we acquire those companies, we can really add value because we've done our homework and our due diligence.
Yours is a great story. I'm glad you shared it with us. We'll talk to you again soon, I hope.
Thanks, Scott. Good talking to you.
All right, you be well. It's Musin Mohammed joining us there. Ask Halftime.